touch the world. But it couldn't fill me. Melt empty praise and treasures of faith. Oh, there's nothing.
Good evening and welcome to our event. We are excited to be joining you virtually tonight, even though we can't be having our event tonight in person as we've done in past years. We are excited to share what's been going on with Place of Grace with you all, with the community of Huntington, and now past that for some of you that might be joining us from other communities that may have some sort of connection to Place of Grace. We're excited you are able to join as well. We are hopeful that we'll be able to reach more people with our mission because of the technology that we've been afforded through this event tonight. So a big thank you to Life Church, as they are our virtual hosts for the evening. They have been helping us with the technology portion of this program, and so we're just really thankful that they have been willing to help out and make this a possibility. For those of you that are unfamiliar with what Place of Grace is, we are a women's transition home here in Huntington County. We serve women who are exiting incarceration and reentering the community. Our women are stuck in destructive cycles of addiction, abuse, and poverty, and it is a part of our program to help them discover what it looks like to live a life of recovery and a life connected with Jesus and connected with their community. We have been serving women for 3.5 years here in Huntington, and I'm excited to see where we've come from and where we're going. So tonight you will have the opportunity to share hear stories from some folks who have been a part of Place of Grace in a number of different ways. Some have been in the program, some have had a loved one in the program, and some have been connected as volunteers. So excited to share some of those stories with you, and hopefully you will be as encouraged as we are as you hear them. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Sharon Metzger. I am the executive director at Place of Grace. I was brought on to help develop this program and have had the opportunity to see it flourish over these past few years, and just really excited to see how far we've come with all the people that have been a part of the program. Since last year's event, a lot has happened. For a lot of people, their lives really came to a screeching halt in March. But for us at Place of Grace, that did not happen, and the work did not end. Not only did the work not end, but it became all the more necessary. Johann Hari is famous for saying, "The opposite of addiction is not sobriety. The opposite of addiction is connection." This is true for all of us, that we all need connection, and our sisters and brothers in our community who are struggling with addiction are no exception to that. Connection is necessary and essential for recovery from a substance use disorder. And that is really one of the main roles that Place of Grace has. It's connection to other participants in the program, connection to staff, volunteers, and also the larger community with churches and other organizations that can help with each person's journey. So, you know, as we have seen the world changed around us, it became necessary for us to isolate in order to protect our physical health. And as we were seeing this physical isolation that was necessary, we saw a pandemic combined with a drug epidemic, and the results are concerning to say the least. It's really too early to know the long-term effects from that, but the information we're starting to hear tells us that likely we have seen COVID-19 and the steps we've had to take fan the flames on an already rampant drug use issue in our community. So we know that places like Place of Grace are now more important than ever. Over the past 3.5 years, we've been serving women in Huntington County, and we've discovered more information about what makes our women's experiences unique. We have seen some of the things that have kind of led up to these destructive cycles that our women enter into. And, you know, it's important to hear stories. It's important to know individuals in situations like that. But it's also important to kind of see some numbers and statistics behind that, because it gives us a growing understanding for what our women are going through and a growing compassion because of that. And sometimes it's more important to change the question from why did you do that or what did you do to what happened to you. And as we hear the stories tonight, I think you'll see some of that. But also hearing some of these numbers will hopefully continue to also paint a story for how these women have been hurt. 77% of our residents have experienced domestic violence. 75% started using drugs or alcohol prior to turning 18, so as children. 75% have at least one parent with a substance use disorder or criminal history. 68% have been diagnosed with a mental disorder prior to joining the program. 51% have experienced sexual abuse. 40% have experienced rape. And 36% have experienced child abuse or neglect. And those numbers are pretty sobering, but it's important to hear them. And we don't share this as an excuse, but we share it as an explanation. And it can be really healing for our residents to be on the receiving end of compassion when we choose the route of understanding rather than to judge. It can be a very powerful tool for them to find the courage in order to take control of their lives and seek out healing when they know there are individuals in a community behind them that are understanding and caring. We have had a total of 25 graduates from our program so far, and more women on track to add to those numbers. And those graduates help tell a new story as they complete the program. 96% of them saw an increase in knowledge of community resources. 84% saw an increase in self-esteem. 76% saw strengthening in their walk with God. And 76% saw an improvement in their mental state of health. So those are the numbers that we see at the end of their journey of Place of Grace. And it's not the end of their recovery journey, but it really is the start, and it really sets them up to be in a better place to be successful in their recovery and their faith journey. So for tonight's event, we have a goal to raise $20,000. And we have seen God provide over and over for our organization, and we believe we'll see that happen again. And we believe this so much that we already have committed any amount raised over that $20,000 towards growth as an organization. Our leadership has been intentionally listening to our community to see what direction will be most beneficial to grow in. And we're continually in prayer to see how God is calling us to grow and what role we need to continue to play in the community. So I want to encourage you, especially those of you that are in Huntington County, to sign up to stay in touch with us. You can sign up on our website to receive our e-newsletter, and you can also like our Facebook page, and we will continue to update you on the growth that we are experiencing and the direction we're headed. I want to give a big thanks to Klein CPA. They are our sponsor for the evening. And because of them, the first $5,000 that is given through the event will be donated or will be matched by them. And thanks to an anonymous donor, the next $1,000 will also be matched. So it's $6,000 that's already going to be matched by some generous donors by you all as you give to this this special event. So you will see a button that you can click above the chat feature that will show you where you can give financially to Place of Grace. And it's also where you can see how close we are to our goal. So I hope you'll do that throughout the evening. And we'll be giving you updates in the chat feature about how close we are to that goal as well. So as you hear stories tonight, we once again hope you are encouraged and hope you see how the work that we do at Place of Grace doesn't just affect one person, but it's a ripple effect. As one person in our community pursues health, growth, and change, that's amazing for them. And thankfully, at Place of Grace, we get a front row seat to that. And it is very motivating to continue to do this work because we get to work with some of the most amazing women. And as one person's life changes, that has a positive impact on the people who love them most. And when families find healing, our community grows. And we're so glad that you're here to celebrate that with us tonight.
We are a Place of Grace. From our house to yours, thank you for giving us hope.
Hi, I'm Jenny Walker, and I came to Place of Grace in October of 2019. And before I got to Place of Grace, I was broken, I was lost, I was trying to find healing in all the wrong places. It began when I was 16. I went to a party, which I then got sexually assaulted at. And after that point, I was running from everything. I was running from my feelings. I was running from just anything that made me feel the way that I did. I didn't necessarily know it at the time. I thought that I wasn't aware what had really happened. And I think that was part of me coping with it. I was pushing it down so far, and I was pushing it down with drugs, with alcohol, anything that would take it away from me. So the moment that I saw a little bit of my life coming back together was actually in a time of despair where most people wouldn't think that that was a good time in their life. I got arrested in 2016, which made me stay in jail for about 4 months. And I didn't find healing in jail, but it did make me sit down and think a little bit more about what was going on in my life. After that incarceration, I got out. Again, I wasn't healed, and I ended up overdosing at my parents' house, which violated my probation, and I ended up going to a treatment center in Kentucky for about a year. And again, I still wasn't getting what I needed. I wasn't focusing on the things that got me there. I was just kind of there. And that's really what I had been doing for the most of my recovery, was just going along with it, making it look like it was okay, and not really working on any of the internal things that brought me to where I was. But I moved back home after that trip to Kentucky. And again, I started doing the same things that I was. And I ended up getting arrested again, which this time was the time that when I got out, I knew that I needed something. And I felt differently than I had ever in the past. Usually I would just go to a rehab or a program, and it would be for my parents, it would be for the courts, it would be for everybody else but me. And this time getting out in 2018, I knew that I needed more. So I went out and I went to a place in Indy, and I left midway, and then I came back home and went to a place. And then throughout that, 10 months later, I knew I was about to graduate the place that I was in, and I knew that what I was getting there wasn't what I needed. I already had it made up in my mind that I was going to leave that stage where I was graduating and I was going to use. And I truly believe that if the Place of Grace hadn't come across my mind and I hadn't decided to apply there, I don't know where I would be today. I don't think I would be in the same place. Coming to Place of Grace completely changed me. I found freedom there. I found healing. I found myself back again, which I think was the most important thing, because throughout the last 12 years, that's the person I've lost. And I found God there too. I've mended relationships. I have relationships with people there, which is the most important thing, accountability. That's something I'd never done before. I'd never stayed in contact. I help out at the house, and I'm forever grateful for that. It serves me just as much as it does them. I hopefully in the future will have more to do there, and I'm just super excited. So as of today, I recently just got a promotion at my job, which comes a lot of responsibility, which I never thought that that would be given to me, but it's because these people have seen me and I've proved myself and I'm going places that I never thought I would go. And I have a puppy, Grayson, which I am super excited about because to me, that is just the responsibility that I thought I could never take on, especially in my mess, because that's something I have to be responsible for. And I wasn't even responsible for myself. So just looking at him, and his name is Grayson, because it is, to me, the representation of God's grace. And every time I look at him, that's what I want to be reminded. And Place of Grace had a little bit to do with that as well. But just today, I am happier, I am healthier, I am more joyful, and I want to bring others to the same freedom and the joy and the happiness that I have.
We are Place of Grace.
From our house to yours, thank you for giving us a future.
My name is Christine Walker, and I am the parent of Jennifer Walker. The road for addiction has been a long road for us as parents. You never want to go down that. It is so heart-wrenching, and there are no words, because financially, spiritually, holy as a person, it just takes you down another journey that you never planned to go down. You know, when I held Jenny in my arms as a mother, you never expect for that young baby that's smiling back at you to be the same child that you're holding in your hands due to an overdose. But the grace of God pulled Jenny through many, many times and many seasons that her father, myself, had given up hope of seeing that change in her life. But God had other plans for Jenny. It's a beautiful thing, and it is a beautiful journey when we can look at it today. But the journey takes a road that takes many people along the journey, many individuals that play a part in this whole road to recovery. It's a beautiful journey when you see other people coming together and being a part of that. You know, when Jenny was 16, as a parent, I thought, well, this is what every teenager is going through. I knew there was something not right with Jenny at that time. She became very withdrawn. I just thought it was adolescence. She didn't want to be around her family, didn't want to be home. I think you're just starting with addiction just to think that maybe it's something that the teenager is going through, maybe the family is going through. You don't quite understand it. And I think as a parent, her father and I didn't quite understand all the signs that were before us in the life of a person that has an addiction going on. You do a lot of things that are right, but you do a lot of things that are wrong. And I'll tell you, addictions cost not only for the individual that it is their life, but it is for the family financially. We have given thousands and thousands of dollars to help her in this process. Jenny was on a quest for searching for herself. For the first time, I saw my daughter choose a place all on her own. As a parent, it was a wonderful thing. At the same time, it was very hard because the journey has been so close, as we're a close-knit family. But it was huge to be able to allow her to make a decision to come to a place that she felt she needed, a place that could give her love unconditionally, a place that she could grow as an individual, and a place that she chose to be there to heal. It added on some time for her probation, which her father and I knew that then God was working on her heart, and she knew exactly where she was heading. God did a beautiful work. I watched my daughter become this individual that couldn't make decisions on her own, call for appointments or just the color of an outfit to wear, that she became the person that can make decisions for herself as an adult. I saw a young woman starting to emerge, become a beautiful woman through the whole process at Place of Grace. The people that surrounded her not only loved her unconditionally, they gave her room to grow. They gave her room to just spread her wings, be Jenny, and love her through every hurt, every despair, every high, every low, and really start to rebuild. Grace gave Jenny so many opportunities to grow inside with the community that would come into the home, but also outside through the mentors and just the partnerships of churches and organizations in her workplace. I saw her blossoming right before our eyes. I saw her with dreams and desires that we had always hoped for when I held that little baby. You know, you have dreams and desires as a parent, but she was starting to gain those within her own. Most of all, I saw God give her hope that he took the broken places of her life and he was allowing that healing to take place. And he was using Place of Grace and the community of people that surrounded her to do that. I'm very proud to say that every step of the way, we've been proud of our daughter. But I can say tonight, I'm deeply proud of the woman that she is today and the woman that she is becoming tomorrow. It takes a lot of individuals to pour into the life of one individual. And when local authorities, business owners, individual donors can give to Place of Grace, what you've done financially, whether you gave of your time or you gave of your resources or you gave financially, you have been a part of making my daughter's journey come back. The success that we see at Place of Grace that I see through my daughter has taken the route of from physicians to individuals that have been counselors to people that have poured deeply financially to surround her. It's just been an amazing thing. Community is a great part. The mentorship that and the friendship that Place of Grace instills with each of the women there is continuing on in Jenny's life. And I am so deeply grateful to see that those are lifetime commitments. It wasn't a one-time commitment to come in and maybe serve. It really is about a lifetime investment. And I want to thank every contributor, every person that gave up their time, especially for my daughter. Thank you, because you've given us a lifetime of memories more with our daughter.
We are Place of Grace.
From our house to yours, thank you for providing a beautiful home for our women.
Hi, I'm Dr. Janelle Maxwell Flieger. Sitting next to me is my husband, Dr. Matt Flieger. We're both family physicians here in Huntington. We started Cardinal Family Medicine back in 2016. And shortly thereafter, we became involved with Place of Grace in a number of ways. The most favorite way that I've become involved is once a month, we take turns, Matt and I, between attending a class, basically, to offer medical education, but in a less formal way. We're in a living room at the house. We sit around. It's pretty casual. I often show up in my yoga pants. So yeah, I think, you know, one of our missions has always been to remove barriers to healthcare, and so, you know, we try to keep it pretty casual and unintimidating because, you know, I think the residents have had a number of encounters with healthcare along their journey. Not all have been positive. And so, you know, as healthcare professionals, we want to be available, answer questions so that people are getting the right information. You know, from a personal standpoint, I think one of the reasons I became involved is because I think as primary care physicians, we had some amends to make in terms of our role in, you know, not judicious prescribing of opiates. And so that's an area we received a lot of medical education, and it turns out that we weren't necessarily treating pain in the most appropriate manner. And so everyone's familiar with the pain scale. You know, a 1 is good, a 10 is bad. And if our patients were experiencing a 7, that meant we weren't treating their pain adequately. And so, you know, opiates, we were told, were a great way to help manage pain. And, you know, in retrospect, it seems like the worst idea. But as we were in it, we weren't quite making that connection. And so sitting across from a patient who was on chronic opiates, inevitably they were still experiencing pain. Oftentimes they would describe it as a 10 out of 10. So that told me that these medicines weren't working. They weren't able to, you know, at that point we had created an addiction. And so, you know, we were at an impasse and it created a problem. And so we can see how that's played out in society in a number of ways. And so I think, you know, I will continue to be involved in Place of Grace. And as part of that, you know, is my way of, you know, making medicine safer for everybody and making amends.
And I would echo what Janelle was saying, and I would kind of add to, like, hello, my name is Matt, and I'm a reformed opiate prescriber. And I think we do have this big amends to make. And I remember from my previous practice how I had inherited kind of a lot of pain patients and was prescribing a lot of pain medicine. And it wasn't always comfortable to do, but you felt like you were kind of stuck prescribing it because you knew if you wouldn't prescribe it, then they would jump to heroin. And so you're trying to keep them close. And I had a lot of bad outcomes with patients who would overdose on these medicines. And it was heartbreaking. But within the medical system, we didn't have a way to address their true needs. And so we felt like we were harm reducing then at that point. And we were just in a vicious cycle. And so, you know, fast forward and we come here and coming into the community in Huntington, and then we meet Sharon and the people who have been working on figuring out Place of Grace for 10 years prior to when we even arrived. And it just was so exciting because it's what we had been hoping for back in our previous practices before we had moved to Huntington. And so I think we saw that as like a big blessing. And so we wanted to be involved in Place of Grace. There was no denying that fact that we wanted to be involved. And so luckily, they took pity on me and they let me on the board, and which has been really great. And then Janelle and I have been able to do these health talks. You know, also through this process, some graduates have become our patients in one way or another. And I had a really interesting interaction with one grad in the past that kind of sums up what I think we're kind of understanding and feeling about everything, which she had had a lot of past trauma that has happened to her and was doing okay, and then things surfaced back again and had a slip up and broke her terms of probation. I asked her, I said, did you talk to Sharon? And she said, oh, no. And I said, why not? And she said, well, I couldn't talk to Sharon about this. And I said, well, why not? I mean, has Sharon ever, like, judged you or, you know, condemned you for your past mistakes? Well, no. But I would feel like I'm letting Sharon down. And I kind of had to help her through this process of saying, your actions don't define who you are. You don't need to have shame about these things. Sharon is not going to judge you. Just like me as a board member, I'm not going to judge you. That's not my role. My role is to support you and help you through this. And we're just going to leave it matter of fact, like something happened, it's okay. And I think in the same sense, what we would hope is that our community can do the same for the women of the house and the grads of the house and also the women who are going to eventually be in the house. That we are not going to judge these women. We're just going to support them. Because we understand that we have grace and God has given us grace. And so the way that we can show that to other people is by extending that grace to people. And we can do that in community. That's, I think, in my perspective, where we see grace happening is in community with others. Obviously, we know addiction is unique. It's complex. There's lots of setbacks. There's people who use again, even after being clean. There's people who do well. It's all over the spectrum. But we need places like Place of Grace sticking with the women through thick and thin. And I think that that is what I've seen Place of Grace do. Through thick and thin, no matter what, shame doesn't belong here. We're with you. And I hope, in light of everything that is swirling in our nation and a lot of stuff is happening, we get that. But let us not lose sight of what's happening just with each other and how we need to support each other. And it's not cheap to invest in Place of Grace or to run Place of Grace. It takes a lot of money to invest in these women. And we're asking you to join with us and partner in with that. We've had a lot of great partners throughout the years, but we need that continued financial gifts to keep the house open. It takes a lot. It's an old house. It needs new HVACs at times. It needs new electricity at times. Things happen, and we need to help continue to support the mission. And so whether you want to support today, get in on the match, which is going to be fantastic, already $6,000. That is matching whatever you donate. If you don't feel comfortable doing that way, you can always mail a check. There, you can even just drop off cash at the door to Sharon. She will take your money. It's okay. And so whatever way that looks like, please join with us. And if, you know, financially that's not a situation, you can find out other ways that you can support. Reach out to Sharon. She knows of things. There's an Amazon list that has things that are needed by the women or the house that you can support. That you can support in. So there's a number of ways, but I would just ask you, let's be community to those women. Let's join in with them and bear each other's burdens.
We are Place of Grace.
We are Place of Grace. From our house to yours. From our house to yours.
From our house to yours.
From our house to yours. Thank you for investing in life transformation.
Well, now is the time when I would have asked our guests to give a round of applause because we had such amazing speakers tonight. Obviously, we can't do that, but I hope that that was the response you felt like giving, because I always tell people we have the most amazing people involved with Place of Grace. The staff are amazing. Our volunteers are amazing. The residents, the graduates, the mentors, our board members, and the community that supports all of them. And I wish you could see all of that, but tonight we hope that we gave you a bit of a glimpse into that. So, Jenny, I was hoping that you would share with the folks that are watching at home what it means to you when you see the community coming around Place of Grace and support.
For me, seeing everybody come in, that was one of the most important things to me, because that's where I felt the love from others. That's where I saw them actually care. And to me inside, it meant a lot, because when you're out there in addiction, you don't feel like anybody really cares about you. So to see them care about you on the after fact, and to know that they actually were caring about you during the time you just couldn't see it, it means everything to me. The support, everything.
Thank you. And thank you for sharing your story tonight. That was really lovely. And to have your mom here and share was just great. So
Just want to give one last thank you to all the folks that made tonight possible. Thank you to Klein CPA for sponsoring this event and to Life Church for helping us host this event virtually. And thank you for the folks that helped plan this event, for our board of directors that stepped in and helped, and our staff that were a part of that. Thank you all for making tonight a success and for us to be able to share our mission with the community. As Matt shared, if you are interested in supporting us, there's lots of different ways to do that. If you would like to write a check or give cash, you can do that. We will post our address in the chat feature for you to be able to send those. That information is also on our website. Our website is placeofgracehuntington.com. You can also give financially. The link has been in the chat portion multiple times, and then there's the option to get to that giving website. But if you would like to do that at a later point, you can also donate through our website. As Matt said, we have an Amazon wish list. We have a needs list on our website. All of that can be accessed from either our Facebook or our website. So you can get on there and check it out. If you want to give me a call, I love to chat. So I can give you that information as well. If you're interested in getting involved as a volunteer, there's a volunteer application on our website as well. So thank you all for joining us. We hope you are encouraged. We hope you see how Place of Grace is a part of our community, and hope that you will continue to join us in this celebration and stay connected with us in the future. Have a great night.